Welcome everyone to The New Fly Fisher. I'm your host, Bill Spicer. On this week's show, small stream fly fishing in Southern Ontario. I'm with good friends Stuart and Mary Lou Roxborough, and we're gonna fish Whiteman's Creek. We'll talk about equipment, we'll talk about flies, and we'll talk about strategies. It's gonna be a real good one, folks, so stay with us, we'll be right back.
Look at that fish.
Very good fish.
Another fine, beautiful steelhead taken.
This is a good example of the family haptogeneity. This is why you need a lot of backing.
Do you love fly fishing? Are you wanting to learn how to fly fish? Then subscribe to the New Fly Fisher online magazine. It's free. Each issue is filled with great stories, information on techniques, tackle, and fly patterns. You can view this magazine on your personal computer, smart tablet, or other device. Each issue contains great stories, photography, and instructional video. To subscribe, go to www.thenewflyfisher.com.
On today's show, the New Fly Fisher crew is in Southern Ontario fishing a typical small stream you could find anywhere in North America. This particular small stream holds fond memories for me, as this is where I first learned to fly fish. The solitude, beauty, and challenge of this stream made me want to pursue this wonderful sport of ours further, and have since become an addiction with me. Joining me today is Mary Lou and Stuart Roxborough. This husband and wife team of trout enthusiasts is actively involved in Trout Unlimited. They deeply believe in giving back to the resource and the notion that a stream without friends is a stream dead.
It's important that we don't just barge right in. We need to take time to observe the stream itself and see what's happening. There could be a big fish right in front of us. Is this true?
That's true. It absolutely could be, Bill. There could be something big in front of us. Usually in this spot, you may get some bigger fish cruising up, picking on the little guys. But there are some small fish rising in the foam line. If we go in to the stream any farther down, we're too close to the next riffle and we'll start to disturb it. So we're better off, even though it's a little more difficult here, to slide in here, look and see if there are any fish really close in, and then just walk down the middle.
So this goes with a pre-planning strategy that you must take for small streams. You just can't barge in, and I've seen another rise over there. This is very encouraging.
Yeah, these will be small, young of the year rainbows mostly, that are rising over in here and feeding right out of the end of that foam line. I was just saying, one of the interesting things is if you come into a spot you know where there are usually small fish, and all of a sudden you find there aren't any, it's usually because a big guy has moved in there.
Right.
And there was a really nice little rise right over there just now. That's really enough talking, and it's time to get in.
I agree with you. Yeah, let's do that. Let's do that.
Never really want to just walk through a piece of water.
Okay.
I mean, you never know when there could be a fish in here. So even if you're just walking down to what you see as the next best spot, and that's the way you planned it, there's no harm in just letting the fly work its way down with you.
Absolutely. You never know if there's a cruising fish.
You never ever know.
Yeah.
You know, and we're seeing a couple little fish playing around the edge. So my technique is usually get in here. It's deep enough, it's cold enough, and instead of just plodding down, just cast flat, just work your way down.
Right. Okay, let's give it a shot. Stuart, you start, and Mary Lou, you can follow behind him. I got a nymph on, so I'm going to wait till I see some better water. I'll watch you two. Work your wet flies, and let's see what happens.
Okay.
Thank you.
What we're really doing here is just trying to work a wet fly just under the surface, just to see if there are any fish that are feeding close to the surface. And we're just doing that as we're walking down to the next riffle, just in case anybody's cruising in through here. And we're just tossing a traditional wet fly out, letting it swing across the stream, letting it swing back. It doesn't necessarily mean there's anybody here, but you just don't want to miss an opportunity.
Oh, and he's a little jumper. Look at that. Isn't that something?
We usually get it on the swing through.
Yeah? Okay. Yeah. And just under the surface, what kind of take was it? Did they slam it?
Slam it. The little guys in here, I don't know if it's because they have to compete with the big boys.
Yeah.
They're very eager for food, and they very rarely take it gently.
Now, small streams, people have to understand, is small fish most of the time. Although there is a chance here to get a really big fish. In years past, we have got them in 20 inches.
Well, I'll tell
but this
you
is know, a typical.
Sometimes you think you got about a 20-incher on.
Yeah.
And you get one of these little guys
right
there. Pretty lively. Nice
okay
little rainbow. Can you just...
And let's just see if I can... Now, the regs are here are single barbless hooks. And so this should just... Oh, nicely.
There we go.
Very good. Oh, that was great. Oh, I like it.
I think the best bet is a multi-mixed approach, especially on any small stream. If you're not familiar with the stream, the best thing for you to do is carry a cross-section of flies in your box, starting from dries all the way down through to nymphs. Watch the hatches. Go with the hatches, whatever the time of day. I find that this time of year, you will be doing some dry fly fishing very early morning, very late evening. That's usually when you're going to have your spinner falls or your hatches with things like olives. Then as the day progresses, if you still want to be out there, you can try traditional wets. Then you can get down to some nymphing if there's no surface action. I would say just bring a little of everything, a real mixed bag. We've been finding over the years that on small streams, fish are opportunistic. It's great to match the hatch if there's one available, but just carry a mixed bag and try a few casts with a certain species or a certain tie. If it's not working for you, take it off and move on to something else.
What I'm really doing in here is, as we're coming down to this next set of structure where there's probably some very prime lies, this area is full of young of the year rainbows, and they just won't stop hitting the fly. They're young and they're active, and sometimes they're almost a nuisance. We just try and be real gentle with them. They'll try and eat just about anything they can get in their mouth, whether it fits or not. But we're just working our way through these small fish. There's another one just started. As soon as the fly hit the water, they're right on it. The fish population's in here. Again, these are small, young fish. Come on. But we know there are some significant ones in here.
It's important to remember on the small stream that you come on stream with the appropriate gear. You're going to want to use small rods. My favorite small stream rod is a 2-weight. I have 2, 3, and a 4. I would not go any higher than a 4 because then you're getting into things that are just, it's overkill. Catching an 8 or 10 or 12 inch rainbow on a 2-weight rod and reel is every bit as exciting as catching that big steelhead on an 8 or 9 weight. It's all relative. The excitement of the experience is all relative to the size of your gear based on your environment. And for small stream fishing, you get a 10 inch rainbow on a 2-weight rod, you get all that excitement. You get all the movement, you get all the fight, every bit as much as you do a big hog. It's important to remember all you really need to bring with you on a small stream is one good line. My own personal preference is a standard weight forward. You can use a double taper, although it isn't necessary. Don't even think or worry about bringing in a sink tip. Even when you get into some of the deep holes in this stream, you want to get down. Some lead shot's all you're going to need for nymphing. Try and keep the gear to minimum. You can't go wrong with a good weight forward line.
Now in small streams, overhead casts are really the less likely cast you want. You must learn a proper roll cast, and all you need to do when roll casting is draw the line up slowly and get the line behind your ear, and all you do is a front cast after that, and it'll roll right out, and anywhere you point your rod tip, that's where the line's going to go. So you can actually be quite accurate with a roll cast just by pointing the rod tip to where you want it to go. Oh yes, and it worked, and this seems like a fairly decent little fish. You know, it's like I say, small streams, it's not so much that you're catching big fish, but this is a decent fish. Wet my net, bring them up, and there we go. This isn't a bad little small stream trout. And it's almost a do nothing type of presentation. You just allow it to swing in the current, let the current do the work for you. As you can see, nothing big, but I'll tell you, I'll catch these all day. They give you all the excitement you need on a little 2 or a little 3-weight rod. And all I did, again, casting down and allowing it to swing across, and right at the end of that fallen tree, that's where I took that fish, and that's, I got the first hit earlier, just before the camera came on. I had a hit there, so I put it right back again, and he took it that time. Pretty good. I can do that all day.
For most small streams, a selection of standard flies is all that's necessary. Flies such as hare's ears, pheasant tail nymphs, stone flies, and caddisfly pupa will take most fish. A selection of soft-tackled wet flies work well as emerger imitations fished just under the surface film.
It's been a long time since I fished down here.
Yeah.
Oh, good going, Stuart. That looks like a decent fish. And I was about to tell you that you had a fish near you. Oh, that's great. Okay. Oh, this one looks great. Here, wet my net, get it ready for you. Oh, this is a decent fish. Very good, Stuart.
Thank you, Bill.
I'll let you unhook it and show it to the camera. Now, you were just swinging a wet fly, right?
Swinging a wet fly.
And the pattern, is that same pattern you had on earlier?
Exactly the same pattern that I had on earlier.
It's a royal wolf. There we go. What a nice little fish. And he took it on a swing, and he certainly hit it hard, that's for sure. Yeah, well, that's a decent little small stream rainbow.
We'll just put him back in and let him go.
And away he goes, yeah. Yeah, that was very good, Stuart. So you're just a quarter down?
Quarter down, swing across. Generally, in this stream, the take is almost always on the swing, at the end of the swing. Rarely is it out in the front.
That's right, yeah, it's usually on a dangle. They probably followed it over, and then when it stops, that's when they hit it.
I cast to the foam line. I think he was in the foam line. He followed it across. He thought it was going to get away from him, and he went for it.
Oh, that's great. Wonderful.
Thank you, Bill. Appreciate that.
Oh, great.
There he is.
Was that on a wet fly, Mary Lou?
Yep. Swing through.
Good.
Seems
looks like
to
a
work,
decent little fish, too.
Works every time. He's a nice little fish. Hold still there.
Very good. Congratulations.
Thank you.
That was great. Isn't this a lovely run? Yes.
It is a nice run.
Oh. This is going to hold some big fish too. We might not get them today, but this does hold big fish. Definitely, definitely. Oh. Not a bad little fish there.
No, not bad.
Not bad little fish. Like I say, I would catch these things all day.
Yep.
They excite me. On a 2-weight rod, you get a nice little fight out of them, and it isn't exactly easy. They'll use all of your skill that you can give them. Good man. Now you're just swinging that again, swinging the wet fly. And it looked like it hit a boat in the middle of the drift there.
I think it hit just as I was relaxing, thinking about what I want to do next.
Yeah. Yeah, and because of the rain, it's roiled up the water a little bit there. It's a little off color now. I think they're a little more active, don't you?
I think they're a little more active, and I think they're moving around.
Right.
You know?
I think the biggest appeal is that fly fishing is all about finesse. It's not about muscle. I'm told that a secure male will admit that women make better fly fishers than men for that reason. It's very cerebral. You really have to focus on the essence of the sport and not let your mind wander. As I say, and ultimately, it's all about brains, not brawn.
Now, Stuart, small streams, stealth is very important. And to be able to stay as far away from the fish as you can when fishing is the utmost importance. This technique really, really proves that. Can you comment on it?
Sure, Bill. You're absolutely right. On a small stream, these fish are spooky. The water's relatively clear. You want to be able to disturb things as little as possible while covering a fair piece of water. Swinging a traditional wet fly lets me work from probably 20 to 40 or 50 feet out. That was a hit, too.
That was a hit there, yeah.
Without moving my feet at all, and I'm covering most of the stream, just quietly standing here and casting and letting a wet fly swing down through and putting it past the fish. Usually works very well. You know, today we've been getting a number of fish on wet flies just with this technique, and as I've been standing here talking to you and not really paying attention to what I'm doing, I've had two good hits in this pool, right at the end of the swing, not at the dead drift part, right when the swing's
on
coming.
On the dangle there, yeah.
On the dangle, right when the swing's coming to the end.
Right.
That's when it seems to attract them. And
yeah.
It's a very, very old technique.
You also made point of not moving your feet too much, moving too much in the water, because it does send shockwaves through.
What I found is that a lot of times you can actually walk and it doesn't seem to be that much of a problem. Where the problem comes in is when you're planted in one place and you start to move your feet on the stream bed, and the action of moving your feet on the stream bed shuffles the stones. And that actually seems to cause more problem than actually walking. So it's one of those things. Find the right spot, get planted, relax, and just work down through a stretch. Then quietly move 10 or 12 feet down and work down through the next stretch.
Here's a tying recipe for the pattern I was using today.
This is part of the fun on a small stream too, is when they get hung up around all the debris. I don't think we will, but...
He's still there?
He's still there. Let him relax for a minute. Sometimes they'll just come out. Not much you can do. Can you see him in there, Bill? You got him.
Yep, fish won that time. Oh, there we go. We got a fish on here. Now, this is quite an interesting run here. And I'm actually going to net this little guy here. And there we go. Now, one thing about trout, if you hold them upside down, they calm down. And as you can see, I don't want to squeeze them. They're very delicate. You don't want to squeeze them. So if it slipped out of your hand, it slipped out of your hand. But I was swinging, just like you told me, Stuart, across this current here. You can see a round section of where the pebbles deepen up. He was right there. Small streams, it's not about the size of the fish, is it, Stuart? It's about the experience.
It's about the experience. I mean, what better place could you be?
Absolutely.
Than this. And the passion for me about small streams is the intimacy of this kind of fishing.
Right.
I'm not chucking a fly 60 or 70 feet out into a fast river or into a run.
Whiteman's Creek, one of my favorite places to fish. This is actually where I learned how to fly fish many years ago. I hope you enjoyed today's show and learned a little bit about fishing small streams. For more information on this show and others in our series, visit us on the net at www.thenewflyfisher.com. From all of us here at The New Fly Fisher, thanks for joining us. Tight lines, and we'll see you next week.
Looking for world-class fishing at reasonable prices? Want the best of bass, brook trout, pike, and walleye fishing that is easily accessible? Then come to the Algoma region in Northern Ontario. Easy to access by road, plane, or even train, Algoma features some of the best fishing in the world. To learn more, go to algomaregion.com or call toll-free 1-800-263-2546.